Great to see you. Thanks for being here tonight. This afternoon, it's not night yet. My name is Dave Gardner, and I serve here at University Presbyterian Church as the Director of Worship. And we're so glad to welcome you. On behalf of everyone involved today, I want to say welcome. We're glad that you're here. We're especially excited to welcome two additional choirs that have joined with us for this concert today, Mountain View Presbyterian Church Choir, directed by Chris Mason, and Grace Lutheran Church Choir, directed by John Hendricks. And I'd like to ask anybody from Grace or Mountain View, would you wave at us right now? Yeah, wave up nice and high. Yeah, let's thank them. Well, we call this a concert, but I keep finding myself switching between calling you audience and congregation, because this is an act of worship. We are here to worship our Lord. Even though we call it a concert, it's much more than just a public performance of music. One of the definitions of the word concert is agreement, accordance, or harmony. And our desire is that this concert would give all of us the opportunity to come together in agreement to give glory and worship to our God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The title of the major work we're performing today is Gloria. It comes from the Latin phrase, Gloria in excelsis Deo, which means glory to God in the highest, and comes from Scripture in Luke chapter 2, when the angels are appearing to a group of shepherds to announce the birth of the Messiah, Jesus Christ. Our purpose and our desire in being here today is to ascribe glory and worship to God in the highest. And we want to invite you to worship him together through God's glorious gift of music. Now, we all don't want to keep the singing to just ourselves. We'd like to invite you to join with us. So we're going to sing a couple of carols right now, and then two more a little bit later in the program. And we'd like for you to sing along with us. You can find the words either in your hymnal, the red book in front of you, or also in the program that you picked up on your way in. If you're going for the hymnal, it's number 173. We're going to begin with, O Come All Ye Faithful, and then sing Good Christian Friends Rejoice. As you're able, let's stand. I always feel we sing better when we're standing up. Let's remain standing, if that's okay with you. Isn't it good to break these songs out again? It's been almost a full year since we've sung many of these, and we're getting a tiny little jump on Advent. The next one is number 157, Good Christian Friends Rejoice. I have to make one little announcement about this next piece. One of our featured soloist for this piece, unfortunately, has been ill this week. And so she's not able to sing. She's also my youngest daughter. But she's got a beautiful voice. You'll have to hear it sometime. But anyway, so the solo part is going to be sung by all the women of the choir. And then, but the other small group listed in the program will be singing their part as well.
Thank you.
Thank you, Wade. I don't usually like to talk this much in a concert, but I had to figure out something to do while Wade was running back and forth from the piano to the organ, which he's already done a few times in this concert, and that's why I'm talking right now, to cover some time while he gets to the organ and gets all set for this next piece. So while he's doing that, I want to mention that several weeks ago, I mentioned to the choir here at UPC that I thought it'd be fun to put together a small group, kind of folks selected out of the larger choir, to learn a couple of pieces to do on the Christmas concert. And so in just a few moments, you're going to hear the very first performance of this brand new group. They're going to be doing a couple songs for us after this next Christmas carol. And since Wade's there, I'm going to announce that. We're going to sing together, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. It's number 171 in your hymnal, or of course words also in the program. There's a bit of an instrumental introduction to this, so I'd like you to just stay seated for that so you can really enjoy and appreciate it, and then I'll indicate when it's a good time for us all to stand up to sing together. Thank you. singing Angels We Have Heard on High. Once again, I'll ask you to stand as you're able. Well, oftentimes when you come to a concert, there are program notes. I kind of like to do them verbally. So I want to talk just a little bit about the work you're going to hear in a moment. When you think about it, there are two general moods that we see in the Nativity story. You have the quiet scene at the stable. Yeah, you can sit down, sorry. The quiet scene at the stable with the brand new mother gently rocking her newborn son, and quietly pondering all the events of the night in her heart, as it says in Luke 2:19. This quieter mood is depicted today by songs like the ensemble sang for us a few minutes ago. On the other hand, you have the scene of the angelic announcement. Listen to it here from Luke 2, verses 18 through 14. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of a great joy for all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, we just sang it in Latin, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." I don't know about you, but when I hear those words, the image that pops into my head is of glittering brass instruments and brilliant, shining white light. It says that the shepherds were terrified, and you can kind of understand that. I mean, I'm standing like 5 feet away from some of these brass instruments, and they're just a little bit scary because they can put out a lot of volume. But I have no idea what music will sound like in heaven, far beyond what we can imagine. But here on earth, the instruments that John Rutter chose for this setting of the text are, I think, more suited to declaring God's power, glory, and majesty than any others that have ever been invented. Every single instrument you'll hear, from the mighty pipe organ, the majestic brass, to the powerful percussion, creates its sound either by forcing air through metal or by hitting something. These guys get to hit things, which is fun. The other musical timbre, of course, you'll hear is the only instrument created directly by our Creator, the human voice. The text for this work comes from the Latin Mass and can be traced back through a morning prayer from around 380 AD and to a Greek version from the 2nd century. And of course, the first few lines we know are even earlier than that because we just read them from the New Testament. The Gloria text has been set by countless composers through the ages, but each one treats it a little bit differently. You may know the Vivaldi Gloria. It's broken up into 12 different movements. This one by John Rutter, he's chosen to break it into three movements or sections, and each one has a distinct flavor. The opening movement is fast. It moves at about 180 quarter beats per minute. It's loud and it's often syncopated as the choir quotes the angels from Luke 2 and then goes on to say, "We praise you, we bless you, we worship you, we glorify you." The only quiet moments of the first movement come with the text, "And on earth peace." Listen for how the composer changes the texture to communicate this angelic benediction. The second movement is a prayer for mercy. It begins softly. You'll hear the organ alone for several measures before the men of the choir come in singing, "Lord God, King of Heaven, God the Father Almighty." The prayer builds and intensifies as these words are repeated, and both God the Father and Jesus the Son are addressed. Finally, after a mighty crescendo, we're standing face to face with the Savior, saying, "You who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us." All the instruments fall away, and we stand bare before the mercy of God. Now, confident of our pardon, the third movement is a grand celebration. Mercy has been granted, the burden of sin has been lifted, and the Christian rejoices, giving praise to God from a full heart. When we get to the Amen section, listen for the tempo to get faster and faster, as if we can barely contain ourselves in our excitement. The choir will be singing in Latin, but translations are in your program. We hope you'll follow along. Thank you for coming, and now exalt the Lord with us as we present Gloria.
I have the hardest job. I have to follow that. Wow. Thank you, Dr. David Gardner. Wow. We'll let him sit down and breathe for a minute, but let's thank him. And Chris Mason and John Lennox from the other two choirs. Can you guys stand up so we can see you? There he is. Thank you. Thank you. It is so good to do this together, three churches. What a gift. And I know that as an audience member, we have received a gift, but it goes both ways. And so, musicians, would you thank the audience for their participation? There's a lyric from one of the earlier songs that I want us just to remember. It's a stanza that is taken from Isaiah 40 or inspired by Isaiah 40 and a reminder of what this season is about. Let me read it. He will come in power and glory. He will rule with mercy and truth. Hope of all the nations. Light of all the world. That's who we're celebrating this season, Jesus. Hope of all the nations. Let's remember that. Well, today's concert is free. We didn't have to buy tickets, which was a tremendous gift, but there are costs involved. And so as you leave today, there will be ushers with baskets that you can drop an offering in. If you'd like to do this again next year, let us know and sort of pay it forward, I guess. We'd love to keep doing this, but if you want to leave an offering, there will be ushers standing at the door with baskets. There's a silver box in the back. And if you want to give online, you can go through upc.org/give, and you can give using our online payment method. Just write in Christmas concert in the memo line so we know that that's what that's for. Well, I would like to pray for us before we go. We're going to hear a little bit more music, but let me just pray. If you would join me, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we are so thankful for this opportunity that we have this afternoon to pause and to listen, to sing, to play instruments. All great gifts that you have given to us. And we pray that our offering today is one that you find pleasing. As this music reaches your ears, we hope that you are pleased. And God, we pray that during this month of December, this Advent season, that we would be mindful of the great gift that you have given us in your Son, Jesus, who is the hope of all the nations. We pray in his holy name. Amen.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for coming. John Rutter, the composer of that amazing work you heard a few moments ago, has been quoted as saying, you know, it's wonderful to go to a choral concert, but I think the deepest joy of all is to actually sing. And I think the folks behind me can attest to that. And if being here today has lit a fire in you to sing, right now is a great time to join a choir. It really is. If you're a part of the Mountain View congregation or the Grace Lutheran congregation, you know who to talk to, John and Chris. If you call UPC home or would like to, talk to me. We'd love to listen and have you be a part of the choir, and next time you can be up here as well. The choir is going to sing one more piece that's a benediction, and then we'd like to invite you to go out into the narthex lobby area right out of these doors, and there'll be a light reception, refreshments afterwards. Thanks again for being here.